welcome back to Travel in Chinese. My name is Mark Rosewell, also known as Dashan. In the last few episodes, we've been spending some time in Suzhou exploring some of the gardens in this city, like Zhuozhengyuan, the humble administrator's garden, or Changlangting, the blue wave pavilion. Well, today we're going to look at one of the largest and perhaps one of the best gardens in Suzhou, the garden for lingering in, Liuyuan. We're also going to look into something that you might want to buy when you visit Suzhou. That's Suxiu, Suzhou-style embroidery. Let's take a look at today's dialogue.
这些素幽园的钟最大的厅堂，这些家具真的太好了。这些家具啊，都是楠木的，所以呢，这里也叫楠木厅。这两个房间完全不一样，我的眼睛都不够用了。雪梅，所以这里叫鸳鸯厅啊。鸳鸯不是鸟的名字吗？鸳鸯跟这个厅堂有什么关系？鸳鸯是一种鸟，不过这里的鸳鸯厅呢，是一对的意思。雪梅，你看，这边是男厅，是专门为招待男客人用的。 这边呢是女厅，当然是为了招待女客人用的了。我明白了。哎，雪梅，渴了吧？咱们去那边买点水吧。好的。哎，对了，今天我想买点苏州特产，你能推荐一下吗？
要说苏州的特产真的挺多的，不过人们常买的也就是苏绣、丝绸和檀香扇这几样。
吃的东西有什么特产吗？
吃的东西也很多，依我看，你最好走的时候再买吃的。
好的，走。
雪梅，你看，这就是苏绣，这面和那面是不是一样的？
真的，在这么薄的丝绸上能绣出这么好的东西，真棒！我一定要多买一点送给朋友，谁看了谁都会喜欢。
很好，你没有买苏绣吗？
这就是双面绣，
雪梅，双面绣是苏绣中独有的技法。哎，
苏绣有多长时间的历史了？哦，已经有2000多年的历史了。
怪不得苏州姑娘的衣服那么漂亮。
雪梅，苏绣不限于服装，以前呀还有绣的地图呢。
我觉得这里卖丝绸的多，穿丝绸的也不少。我们这儿是丝绸的故乡嘛。
苏州从元代开始就有丝绸厂了，几乎有700-800年历史了吧。那我一定要多买一些送给朋友。哎，
雪梅，这儿的湖笔也挺有名的，很多外国人都喜欢买。
不光是外国人喜欢，您来时我丈夫还特地嘱咐过我要买这种笔。
哦，我们这儿有卖湖笔的。哦，
谢谢。不过我们还是先买苏绣吧。
好。Okay,
now let's go back over the dialogue part by part. In our last lesson, Xuemei mentioned having seen a scale model of some garden architecture at a museum in the United States. Now she's found the real thing. 这是苏州园林中最大的厅堂. This is the largest building, 厅堂, in all of the Suzhou gardens. 厅 and 堂 both refer to halls, like a concert hall, 音乐厅, or a lobby hall of a hotel, 大堂, a hall. This particular hall is called the Nanmu Hall, after a kind of giant evergreen tree found in southwest China called Nanmu. Literally, my eyes aren't enough. There's too much to see. This is like saying, 两只手不够用了. Two hands are not enough. There's too much work for just two hands. 我的眼睛都不够用了. There's too much for my eyes to see. Now, do you remember when we talked about food in an earlier lesson, we came across the term 鸳鸯火锅. This is a hot pot divided into two halves, one spicy and one plain. Well, here we see this term 鸳鸯, Mandarin duck, again. Remember, these ducks always appear in pairs, so 鸳鸯 is often used to describe two things that go together, two complementary things. Now that means they're not the same, they're just complementary, they work well together. 鸳鸯厅 would be two hallways that somehow match or go well together.
这两个房间完全不一样，我的眼睛都不够用了。雪梅，所以这里叫鸳鸯厅啊。 鸳鸯不是鸟的名字吗？鸳鸯跟这个厅堂有什么关系？鸳鸯是一种鸟，不过这里的鸳鸯厅呢，是一对的意思。雪梅，你看，这边是男厅，是专门为招待男客人用的。 这边呢是女厅，当然是为了招待女客人用的了。
我明白了。
要说苏州特产真的挺多的。Speaking of Suzhou specialties, there really are quite a lot. 要说 is like speaking of, as in, if you want to talk about that, let me tell you. Here, this pattern is followed by 不过 but. There are a lot of local specialties, but most people buy Suzhou embroidery, 苏绣 silk, 丝绸 and sandalwood fans, 檀香扇。要说苏州特产真的挺多的，不过人们常买的也就是苏绣、丝绸、檀香扇这几样。There are a lot of local specialties in Suzhou to talk about, now that you mention it. But most people usually buy embroidery, silk, and sandalwood fans. 雪梅 changes the subject back to food. She's advised, 依我说 in my view, 你最好走的时候再买吃的。You should wait until you're just about to leave before buying food items. 依我说 is a way of expressing an opinion or politely offering your advice. 依 means according to. 依我说 according to my view, according to my advice, or in my view.
雪梅渴了吧？咱们去那边买点水吧。
好的。
哎，对了，今天我想买点苏州特产，你能推荐一下吗？
要说苏州的特产真的挺多的，不过人们常买的也就是苏绣、丝绸和檀香扇这几样。
吃的东西有什么特产吗？
吃的东西也很多，依我看你最好走的时候再买吃的。
好的，走。
苏绣 is a special kind of silk embroidery found in Suzhou. Su is just short for Suzhou. This is a style of two-sided embroidery, very thin but with one image on each side. 谁看了谁都会喜欢， whoever sees it will like it. This is the pattern 谁 verb 谁 whoever does something. For example, 谁来了谁高兴， whoever comes is happy. In other words, everyone who comes is happy. This kind of embroidery 苏绣 is also called 双面绣 two-sided embroidery or double-sided embroidery. 这是苏绣中独有的技法。 It's a technique uniqueto Suzhou embroidery. 独有 is to be unique. 中国独有的 would be unique to China. You can only find this in China. 苏州独有 unique to Suzhou.
雪梅你看这就是苏绣，这面和那面是不是一样的？
真的，在这么薄的丝绸上能绣出这么好的东西，真棒，我一定要多买一点送给朋友，谁看了谁都会喜欢。
很好，你没有买苏绣吗？这就是双面绣。
雪梅，双面绣是苏绣中独有的技法。
苏州 embroidery is not only found on clothing. 苏绣不限于服装。不限于 means not restricted to, not limited to. For example, we could say, 辣椒不限于四川菜。Hot chili peppers are not only found in Sichuan-style cooking. In other words, they can be found elsewhere, too. In the case of Suzhou embroidery, it used to be used in the production of silk maps, as well as clothing. No wonder Suzhou is known as Sichou de Guxiang, the land of silk. There have been silk factories here since the Yuan dynasty. 几乎有七八百年的历史了。They have a history of close to 700 or 800 years. 几乎 means almost, close to.几乎所有的 almost all, 几乎每一个人 almost every person.
苏绣不限于服装，以前呀还有绣的地图呢。
我觉得这里卖丝绸的多，穿丝绸的也不少。
我们这儿是丝绸的故乡嘛。
雪梅 says, 我丈夫特地嘱咐过我要买这种笔。My husband specially asked me to buy this type of brush pen. 特地 to make a point of,Specially, 特地来看我 made a special point of coming to visit me, came specially for me. 嘱咐 is to advise or to urge. 特地嘱咐 is to make a special point of urging someone. Okay, let's watch that part again.
哎，雪梅，这儿的湖笔也挺有名的，很多外国人都喜欢买。
不光是外国人喜欢，临来时我丈夫还特地嘱咐过我要买这种笔。
Let's take a bit of a break from our language lesson to talk a little bit more about Suzhou. Talking about the special products of Suzhou, most Chinese can give you a long list. The most representative of these are embroidery, fans, musical instruments, lanterns, mahogany furniture, jade carvings, and silk tapestries. Suzhou's arts and crafts are marked by exquisite craftsmanship and represent a unique style developed over 1,000 years under the influence of generations of artisans. With a history of over 2,000 years, Suzhou embroidery, or Suxiu, is considered the pearl of Oriental art for its beautiful designs, varied stitches, superb workmanship, and elegant colors. Early in the Song Dynasty, it was already described as being delicate and close in stitch, and meticulous and wonderful in color. In the Qing Dynasty, Suzhou embroidery enjoyed a period of great prosperity, as these crafts were highly sought in all parts of China. One of the unique features of Suzhou embroidery are the tiny embroidery needles developed by generations of artisans. This has led to a popular saying that wonder can be made with needle points and spring born under the fingers. Now let's take a moment to go over a few of the language points that we came across in today's dialogue. For example, 限于, limited to. Here's a sample sentence. 参加这次比赛的并不限于本校的学生. The people who are participating in this competition are not limited to students from this school. 参加这次比赛的并不限于本校的学. Here's another example. 这部电影只限于18岁以上的人观看. This movie can only be seen by people over 18. It's limited to viewers over 18. 这部电影只限于18岁以上的人观看. Let's go back to the dialogue now and see how they used 只限于.
苏绣不限于服装，以前呀还有绣的地图呢。 我觉得这里卖丝绸的多，穿丝绸的也不少。
Now here's another language point. 特地, to make a special point of something, to do something specially. For example, 我昨天特地去找你，结果你却不在家。 I made a special point of going to find you yesterday or going to see you yesterday, but in the end, you weren't at home.
我昨天特地去找你，结果你却不在家。
Here's another example. 为了这件事，他特地去了一趟上海。 He made a special trip to Shanghai for this task or this issue.
为了这件事，他特地去了一趟上海。
Okay, let's go back to the dialogue now and see how they used 特地.
哎，雪梅，这儿的湖笔也挺有名的，很多外国人都喜欢买。不光是外国人喜欢，您来时，我丈夫还特地嘱咐过我要买这种笔。
Now let's do a little bit of substitution exercise. Let's use the pattern 谁 something 谁, meaning whoever or everyone. For example, 这个地方很不错，谁来了谁都会喜欢. This place is really not bad. Whoever comes here will like it. Everyone who comes here likes it.
这个地方很不错，谁来了谁都会喜欢.
Now let's do a substitution with this 谁 something 谁.
谁有时间谁洗衣服。
谁有时间谁洗衣服。
谁先到谁买门票。
谁先到谁买门票。
谁去苏州谁帮我买点丝绸。 Whoever is going to Suzhou, would you help me buy some silk?
要说苏州特产真的挺多，不过我就想买丝绸。
There are quite a few local specialties in Suzhou, but I just want to buy the silk. 依我说, in my view, the silk in Suzhou is probably the best in the world. Well, that's enough for Suzhou. Next episode, we're going to go down the Grand Canal a little ways to a city often considered the big sister of Suzhou. That's the city of Hangzhou. We'll see you then. 再见。